Good afternoon. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening from wherever you are in the world. And there's people from all over the world. Do you want to put the banner up?
Hello, everybody.
Oh, this is Jen.
I am Jen.
And you can see us live. But this morning, we're going to be doing our Sell or Die podcast. At the very same time, we're doing our 959. And the result of that would be you have to shut the hell up and I have to shut the hell up while I'm doing the podcast part of it. And then I will talk to you about your stuff. Is that cool? Okay, good.
And you can put in comment and we'll go back to them.
Oh, yeah.
But while we're recording the podcast, we're going to get a clean recording.
Yeah. So there you go. So if you're like Mitch Joel from Canada, and you're on the podcast, you're going to have to just keep quiet for a little while and listen. But I can promise you that this lesson will be aha.
All right, let's go. Welcome back, Die Hard.
And welcome back to you wherever you are in the world. So I grew up in New Jersey where people have no patience whatsoever. And lately, it's been more evident that my patience is escaping me. Could be from age, could be from whatever. And Jen is very sensitive to my reactions and challenged me to take a breathing lesson, which is kind of woo when you think about it. How do you fucking breathe? Because you do it involuntarily your whole life, but she has this whole discipline around it. She goes, I need you to meet this guy. His name is Jeffrey Oakes. And he will teach you how to breathe. Therefore, and the outcome of that will be you'll be a calmer, more genteel, not gentile person. And so I said, okay, because I don't want to be known as somebody that goes the wrong way I want to be a nice person, which is hard when you're from New Jersey because they don't breed nice people there. They breed assholes.
It's a choice.
Yeah, but the closer you get to New York, the bigger the asshole you are. Everyone knows that. So I'm talking to this guy this morning, and I'm actually excited about the call. Literally, I'm excited about the call. And he said, I understand from Jen, you're looking to do this and that. And he said, let's look at it as a response rather than a reaction. I said, what do you mean? He said, well, if you're an emergency, whatever they call them, EMTs, you don't react to a situation. You respond. You're called a first responder. And I thought, oh, my God, why didn't I think of that? Why didn't I think of that? And so we spent the morning talking about response rather than reaction through the science of breathing. And I'll tell you what. I can see it in my mind. The visualization process was there that if I simply am willing to take a deeper breath or a different kind of breath, like he gave me this nostril process where you actually have to take your fingers and change them in your hand to where you're blocking. I don't know. He's going to send me a video on it. But it works. It works because it teaches you a discipline. And I threw back at him, if it's easy to do, it's easy not to do, the great Jim Rohn. Simple self-disciplines in life. Small errors in judgment will cost you your career, but simple self-disciplines will lead you to success. And this is a simple self-discipline that I believe will lead everyone to success. So I said, but we need to call this course something that's more New Jersey. He said, what do you mean? I said, I don't want to call it calm down. I want to call it calm the fuck down, which is so much better as a title because it tells you what you need to do.
So I don't know how much you've shared, Jeffrey, about what we have going on personally, but we have a lot of stuff going on personally that we're trying to help Gabrielle get through. And when you're going through something with your family or with loved ones, it tends to create a lot of stress and tension in your body. And if you look back to times where you've been the most sick in your life, I can almost guarantee there was an event prior to that that, I don't want to say caused the sickness, but
created, allowed it to come out.
Yeah, it created acidity in your cells. And when your body is more acidic than alkaline, it does something to the cell structure. And I'm not a scientist, but I know enough about this to be dangerous, that's when, you know, cancer comes and these other diseases that live in our cells and breathe in our cells and come out in a negative way when there's a lot of stress due to the lack of oxidation. And so we breathe normally. Like you all who are listening, you have been breathing this whole time. No one had to say, hey, remember to breathe. Okay.
Right.
Okay.
But take it just for the hell of it right now. Take a real deep one. Then block one nostril and breathe out the other one.
Oh, wow. That is cool.
It's a discipline that once you understand it, and I'm thanking Jeffrey Oakes for it personally, he gave me this new awareness. Now, there's one other thing that Jen's not talking about, and that is when you're with your family, they know you well. They know you intimately. And they can trip your trigger by saying one thing one way or the other that they know you don't like or they know you don't want to hear, and it automatically sets you off. And when you're set off, you tend to lose your discipline. And so I have to learn how to not be set off. I have to learn how to rediscipline my soul, either through meditation or through breathing, that will allow me to be not a kinder, gentler person, but more of one that responds in the positive than triggers the negative. And I think that's where we're at on this. And I wonder what does it for you.
So the thing I was going to add before is that when you create a breathing practice where, so we breathe every day, we breathe every minute we're breathing, and it's unconscious, which is the right word, without thought, right? It just happens until it doesn't happen anymore.
Subconscious would be the word. Okay. Unconscious would be you're knocked out on the canvas.
We want you to be subconscious.
Hit you in the face with a shovel.
Okay. And when you create intention with breath and you do different things, like in the morning, I have my own breath work routine that's different from Jeffrey's, and you're able to get the breath low and slow into your belly and then all the way out. And yeah, that does sound woo. Okay. But low and slow, and this is what my coach Mark England taught me, that low and slow creates the flow.
Oh, wow.
High and tight.
He's a poet and doesn't know it.
High and tight.
But his feet show it. They're Longfellows.
Oh my God. High and tight creates the fight. Or maybe not creates, but that's where the fight, when you're in fight or flight, your breath is caught up here, right? So you want to get your breath low and slow. And when you do that, and when you're able to do that, you're able to not only react differently, but also respond differently.
And recover better. And that whole thing is the discipline of resilience, which I've written about an awful lot, but I didn't realize. I thought it was about an action, not a trigger. If you've been triggered, you're going to go off. There's no doubt. It's part of the trigger process. Someone has tripped your trigger and it has made you either sad or angry or reactionary in a way that you might not like when it's done.
And if you come at it from a standpoint as you get to control the trigger, you get to pull the trigger.
Yeah.
The trigger is never pulled on you. You get to pull the trigger. You get to decide when it gets to be pulled. It's a whole different story and mindset. And so when I think about how this relates not only to your life, but also to your sales and your business, when you're going into a meeting and you're all stressed out, you're not thinking in the best way, right? Because you're like the stress and the breath is caught up here and it's like, ah. Whereas when you can calm down and calm your body down, you can be more creative. You can think more clearly. You can offer better suggestions, better thoughts, better ideas. And so it's not only, this is not just something that will impact your life. It's something that will impact both your business and your life.
So let me throw this at you. If you walk into a sales call and you're all nervous, it's probably because you're unprepared or not prepared enough to feel reassured that you're going to make this sale or make this connection or transfer your message. Interestingly, in life, you're not prepared either. Like, I'm not prepared for the triggers that come at me, and I got to prepare myself deeper, better. And someone is more capable of tripping my trigger as a result of being unprepared, me being unprepared. So I intend to become a more prepared person so that my responses, I'm not going to lose my humor, I'm not going to lose my sense of life, but I am going to gain more self-discipline in the way I respond to other people in a way that may be more pleasing to them.
I think that's so powerful because you always talk about preparation for the sale, preparation for your client, and how you have to prepare in terms of them.
Yeah.
And what you're saying now is before you can even prepare in terms of them, you have to prepare in terms of yourself, and you have to prepare yourself to prepare in terms of them.
And get past the woo, because it's not really wooey, it's lifey. And when you realize that it affects your life in a way that's negative, the first thing you have to do is change it. And if you don't change it, you're going to lose it. If you don't change it, you're going to lose it. And especially,
and if you do change it,
you're going to win it.
Ooh.
Yeah, woo.
Ooh.
So diehards, if you're out there, I'm challenging you to become a bit more self-disciplined, maybe take a breathing lesson, or at least try to understand what breathing is about, and try to put yourself in a greater state of calm, a greater state of understanding, so that when you respond to somebody, you are a first responder, not a first reactor.
I'm thinking of putting together a breathing video on my morning, like my morning practice, how to do that. If that's something you'd be interested in, let me know if you want to
watch. Just
put
your credit card number and your expiration date in the chat box, and we will get back to you with an unlimited bill.
No.
Don't forget that expiration date.
I will take that. However, I wasn't actually looking for that in this moment. If this is something you're interested in, let me know. I'm definitely putting something together for my mastermind clients. And I'm just curious if there's more of a desire out there for something like this that could really set your foundation. And what I call, Jeffrey doesn't like this term, but I do, what I call ground you in the morning.
To me, a grounder is something that you hit the shortstop and it's a double play. So I'm, what do? We ground it out.
Well, I think about the planes that are being grounded because they're being held safe from the storm.
Ah.
And so you're grounding yourself to prepare for whatever the storm may be that day.
Got it.
Until next time, diehard, I'm Jen Gittimer.
I'm Jeffrey Gittimer, and I'm reminding you to respond in a way that others will take it as positive, not reactionary negative. Cheers. Okay, so the podcast is over, and now it's time to respond to the Randalls of the world. In keeping with theme of love and gratitude, a loving person lives in a loving world. A hostile person lives in a hostile world. Everyone you meet is your mirror. Ooh,
I love that.
That's a good one. And good day to you, Martin. You're number two. Mazda Man is number three. Once you understand that the customer wants to win for themselves rather than buy from you, it's so much better. It's so much better. Yep, that's my quote, by the way, Little Red Book of Sales Answers. Thank you very kindly, Benner. Good morning. Creativity is intelligence having fun. Albert Einstein. Whoa. Fucking Albert Einstein, man. That guy was pretty smart. I mean, you got to I mean, he's Einstein. All right. Thanks, Bradley. How are you doing this morning, bud? And Toru comes in top 10 from Japan. Good evening. Good morning. Hey, hey, Mitch Joel, the great Mitch Joel. 6 pixels of separation, control, alt, delete. 2 of the major books in the modern day of business. I recommend you buy them, read them, and put them into practice. Ingrid, good morning. This is so cool, isn't it? I want to see what people are responding. Brucey, you already know what to do. You're just not doing it. One sentence, Jeffrey Gittimer. Exactly. That's a good one. That's a really good one. Battleground Michigan is here. I'm so happy. Or Washington, I mean. I'm so happy to see that. And all the guys that are here, LA, of course. Happiness happens when your conscience is not dominated by addictions and demands. Ooh. And you experience life as a parade of preferences. Ken Keyes Jr., Handbook to Higher Consciousness. I'm going to see what that guy is. Is that an old book or a new book, Randall? Ken Keyes Jr. I'll send it to myself and see what it's all about, and that's final. Final vinyl. We're doing the revised logo for the sales club. You're going to love it. But in the meantime, Dr. Gordon is recovering well, thanks to your prayers.
Hi, Renee.
And Rings is from Mississippi. And welcome from Mississippi. ABL, always be learning. Exactly. Why read self-help books when it's someone else's book? There you go. God's morning, blessings to all, miraculous Monday, on location, podcasting, pretty groovy. Thank you, Eric. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. John Lennon, man. It's funny, I have a nightshirt and that quote is on it. There you go. And Ring says hello to Jen. And the Philippines has checked in. And William has checked in from Lumberville. Just breathe. From Cynthia, good morning. 959 is from BC. This kid, Craig Hall, is pretty smart, by the way. If you get up in the morning and think the future is going to be better, it's a bright day. Otherwise, it's not. Elon Musk. Yeah, no disagreement there. Anytime there's a change, there's an opportunity. Yep. Coachman, good morning. Oh, bless. How do you know all these people's birthday, Coachman? We need to know that. Inquiring minds want to know. Oh, Terrence Whitman just put up a breathing video.
Oh, cool.
Let's check it out. We'll see what's going on there. How many of you have ever taken a lesson in breathing? Put a 1 in the box if you've ever had a breath lesson. Because for me, it was my first. I'm from New Jersey. I know how to fucking breathe. Eh? Hey, I already know what I'm breathing. You know what I mean? So, but it's different. It's just different. It's better. It's totally better. If I remember and quote you accurately, I'm from New Jersey where people eat their young. That's exactly correct. That is exactly correct. Prayers for Dr. Renee. Their prayers are working. And pray for Ronnie Goodwin's brother, Brad. We'll see how he's doing today. Peace to you all. Thank you. We're going to have peace. Twyman, from a transplanted Midwesterner. Been in Jersey since 1974 and trying to be nice like these folks, it ain't easy. Cool. Everyone says hello to everyone. Lana, how you doing, honey? Breathing's important, but Jen is right. We need to breathe correctly. We need to breathe right. Jen is interrupting everything by listening to video, listening to audio. Thank you. Friend taught me to breathe from my diaphragm years ago. Yeah. I learned that when I had throat operations, I learned, I now involuntarily speak from my diaphragm. It's wonderful. Everyone's saying good morning to everyone else. That's always nice. And Pakistan has checked in. Gotta say hey, right? Someone from Pakistan. And Norway has checked in. And the country of California. There used to be a slogan, New Jersey, the armpit of America. Yeah, and when you came to Secaucus, which is the stinkiest town in America, their water tower looks like banned deodorant. So that's how I always looked at it, as it's the armpit and they have the deodorant right there.
That's funny.
Yeah, it's hysterical. It's so good to just see everybody here this morning willing to go. I'm going to talk about some other stuff tomorrow, but I love how people shout each other out. Conscious knowledge of one's own character and feelings motivates and desires. Gary Vaynerchuk, a person who swears way too much. Stress reduces immune system. Ooh. It does. Taru gets another shout out. Mazda gets a shout out. Oh my God, this is so good. Isn't this your guy, the Wim Hof method? Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is what Jen's learning right now, the Wim Hof method. I would challenge you to take it. What's next? Move to California? And no, not even if it would help the space program, although it is kind of emptying out right now. And that might be an indicator of what's really happening in California. Even the people in San Francisco are getting pissed off at what's going on. Isn't that cool? Mm-hmm. About time. Oh my God, that happened to me Friday. Oh my God. Family member trigger is still, exactly. They know how to get
deep
to
breath,
you.
Deep breath, Phil, deep breath.
Family knows how to push your anger buttons. Of course they do. Who wants or needs a kinder, gentler Jeffrey Gittimer? No, I'm not going to be kinder, gentler. I'm just going to respond in a way that creates more positivity. How about that? I am not going to be kinder, gentler. I will continue my dicky ways.
Good.
But I will take the other person more into consideration rather than simply insult them or trigger them in the wrong way. Deep breath process learned at our retreat is amazing. I use it hourly. Cool. Rebecca, how are you? Would love to have you on live talk with Becky. Never say never. Send an email to helpme@gittimer.com and we'll take a consideration. Renee Gordon, have an amazing day. I agree. Good morning. Mary Riley, good morning. You probably already did alternate nostril breathing, soothes the nervous system, harmonizes the masculine and feminine energies, known as the sun and the moon breath. Cool. See, we get learning on top of learning. I love it. Yeah, exactly. Remember Trigger the Horse? Of course, Ray Rogers and his horse Trigger, his Wonder Horse Trigger. He was a Wonder Horse. Wow. Schneider gets a shout out. Another shout out. That was Roy Rogers, exactly. Anyway, everyone's blessed. Everyone's breathing. Everyone's doing the right thing. Amen. Not prepared. Exactly. Just totally not prepared. Simple test in stressful situations. Do a check and see if you're breathing from your chest area only. Your stomach expands. That's correct. It does. But you have to do it in the right way. You breathe in first and then let the air out of your throat as you talk. And that will create an empty stomach and automatically another breath. Just saying. We can adjust.
That's right.
Exactly. Exactly. Sneed is a pretty smart guy.
Yeah.
Good morning, John. Exactly. Renee, we're so happy you're getting better, honey. So happy. Sales lessons and life lessons, the double benefit. Agreed. Good morning from the Maricá Valley, Rio de Janeiro. Cool. There you go. Ipanema Beach. Boom. The girl from Ipanema Beach. People don't realize that Ipanema is part of Rio. You don't have to dance. I'm just saying. Take the worry out of selling.
It's one of your articles.
Yeah, I know. I'm going to go to that. Make sure I got it. I'm sure I always smile before I take a picture. You know what I mean? Because you have to. But that might be part of this whole, you already know what to do. You're just not doing it. Mm. So we'll see how that works. But thank you, Benner. Mark and Sherry Benner are my historians. It's just totally cool.
I love it.
Yeah, me too. I'm grateful for it. Get past the woo in all that you do. I think you have to add a little woo so that it becomes like, whoa, it's so cool. You know, it's not woo, it's whoa. There's a difference. Whoa, it's so damn cool.
The little pink book of breathing.
Yeah, exactly.
I love that.
Duncan, right on the money. Woo for the wind. give us a health report. You woke up today, 150,000 people did not get that opportunity today. Wow. Make it a great day. Holy shit. Well said, Bill. Very well said. And Bill is going to be, he's now a future father-in-law. Yet another chance to be a grandfather. Hope it's working out. It has to. You're in the Midwest. Everything always works out in the Midwest. Laughter yoga is international. Finally. Oh, wow. Laughter yoga? Cool.
I've never heard of it? No.
You want to take it? Put it in there, things you want to do. I want to find out what it is also. You have a link? Mary, you have a link? So we're already at our moment. Can you flip?
One for Jen.
There you go. Another one. See, people are wanting us. I like
it. All right, cool. I will put something together for you guys before the end of the year.
Yeah, so there. And it'll be very inexpensive. It'll be $9.99, but not $9.99. Hey, we're from New York. Grounded is a good word. I like the word centered.
Yeah.
You know, I think it's centered me is more like this, you know, that you're centering as opposed to grounded where you're just like laying on the ground and going, I dare you to move me. Or grounded coffee. Exactly.
Oh,
exactly.
Man.
Great stuff. This is Make a Sale Monday. It's exactly what it is. Isn't it cool, these comments? I totally love them. I get reminded often from my watch to take a minute to breathe. Thank you, Jen and Jeffrey. Very important to put importance in yourself and your body. I concur, William. And by the way, William, I gave you an acknowledgement on Sunday when I had pancakes. Hector, thank you. Are you in America, Hector? Or are you far away? See, I always love when people are far away. Gladys, good morning. I have teenage twins. Breathing exercises are required.
Exactly.
That's a classic. Let me tell you what, my twins are 49, still required. Exactly. Eric, good morning. Daniel, good morning. Have lunch while watching Jeffrey. Oh, having lunch is probably what you meant. That's okay. Breathing's work routine because you have pearls of wisdom and I'm interested in yours. Ah, cool. Glad you're feeling better, Renee Gordon. Me too. Ken Keys, 1972. It's not that bad. Not that old. Okay, cool. Joining late, working, pipeline full. Re-listen to this one. It's a damn good one. Sometimes miracles are just good people with kind. I agree. Miracle morning. Happens all the time. Do it to yourself. Do not learn how to react. Learn to respond. Isn't that classic? You have no idea. Oh my gosh. Chad. Breathing is another facet to maintaining composure and better control. Not dissimilar to drills we did in the Navy. Slow is smooth and smooth is fast. Whew. You know what? I hate to tell you this, but I have to save this. Pretty damn good. Chad Eaves is smart. I'm glad you had the discipline of the Navy. It has helped every single person on this live. How about that?
Chad Eaves is in CEO Club.
Chad Eaves is in CEO Club, and Chad Eaves is a good, he's a real good guy.
He is. He is a great guy.
He lives in Bumfuck, but he's a great guy. Look, more ones, more ones, more ones, more ones, more ones. Lewis, one you, damn one you. You have more energy at 75 than most people do at 25. You're correct, sir. Another one, another one, another one.
What one, are the one, ones? Oh, if they've never had a breathing lesson?
Yeah.
Wow.
Interesting. No, if you have had one.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Great technique is to pretend your nostrils are in your stomach. Ooh. Ari Morgan, how do you say your last name? Mangan. Ari Mangan is the Mexico City Jew. And he is. And he's a classic. His wisdom is scary. So hats off to you, Ari. And we're going to meet in San Miguel, by the way. Is that cool?
I'm excited.
Yeah, I would love to do that.
Best guacamole ever.
Yeah, true. And salsa. The salsa, best guacamole ever. Two best in one place at Casa Sierra Nevada, where we will be staying. Scuba diving. Oh, wow. That's pretty interesting.
Yeah, that is good.
Yeah. Meditation teaches breathing. Yes, it does. This isn't so cool.
Mm-hmm. We have to
go
record our next episode.
Oh. Okay, we have bigger fish to fry, no offense. The clever cat eats cheese and breathes down the rat holes. Oh my God, with bated breath. W.C. Fields. Mm-hmm. Oh my God, that's classic. Ronnie, glad to see you back in humor. Although I probably feel like it never left you. Correct? Brad is working his way through this journey with new stem cells. Thank you for all your support. Cool. We're hoping for him. We're praying for him. Yeah. Playing softball reduces stress. Lots of deep breathing. And what people don't understand is the baseball phrase, keep your eye on the ball. You keep your eye on the ball until it meets the bat. That's what they've done. They leave the left part off, which is so important. Mm. Keep your eye on the ball. When you're swinging, you keep your eye on the ball until it meets your bat, and you'll always hit the ball. Mm-hmm. Just saying. Oh,
I
wow.
I love that.
That's really good. Deep breathing brings deep thinking. Shallow breathing brings shallow thinking.
That's brilliant, Ken. Quote by Elsie Lincoln Benedict.
Is it? Mm-hmm. Is that what the next thing says? Well, there you go. That Lincoln Benedict boy, he was smarter than Benedict Arnold or Eggs Benedict. Eggs Benedict was a fictional character in a Woody Allen play. Now you're making me do two screen saves so I get this. Who's Lincoln Benedict? Somebody tell me. Isn't it nice you can like put the word out and someone gives you the answer?
Yeah, I love it. Yeah. They can go to Google or DuckDuckGo for you.
Not that we use DuckDuckGo to avoid using Google, but we do. We all have two things in common, relationships and problems. Relationships, of course, cause most of our problems. Wow. That's pretty interesting. Mm-hmm. Well, they certainly cause most of our temporary situations.
Yeah.
They're not deep problems, but they definitely cause a negative reaction more of time than not. That's pretty cool. It's okay to be kinder and gentler, boss. Yeah, it is okay to be kinder and gentler. Just you can't lose your inner sense of what's the best thing to do under the circumstance immediately. And I'm going to be a responder rather than a reactor. I think that's the whole key to this. And that was the whole key to the lesson. Think of yourself as a first responder, not a first reactor, and you're going to win. It's just that simple. And I was like flabbergasted when I saw it this morning. Hello to you, Cindy. Shohola, Pennsylvania. Where the hell is that? As a first responder, I see a course you need based off triage for sales. Whoa.
I love that.
Holy shit, Bruce. All right. We'll yak about it. Loopy's Monday night might be next Monday. Not really sure if we're going to be in Charlotte. I don't know what our deal is going to be. We'll see. But it was really nice to hang with Bruce.
Hi, Bruce.
On Saturday. Very, very nice. Bruce Mills, two-word definition, good guy. That's all I'm saying. And Duncan, also good guy, but you live too far away to hang out. We need to figure out a way to hang out. Great one, GS. Key to make the trigger smaller. Agreed. Good morning from the Czech Republic. Now you're talking. Just reading your book about live streams. Cool. You know what? I'm happy to have you here. I've spent many blissful, happy days in Prague, which they refer to as the other Venice. Ooh. The other Paris. Ooh. It's got the structures. There's beautiful, beautiful structures. Mad Magazine from the tune of Girl from Ipanema. Short, fat, bald and ugly. Oh my God. I'm rereading your book, The Little Green Book of Getting Your Way, but not sure it will help with family during the holidays. You know, if you're under 15, this is your time of year to get your way. Just put something on a piece of paper and say you're writing it to Santa Claus and somehow it shows up. What is the live stream book? Age 82. With feet above ground in Indianapolis. It's called Go Live. You can buy it on Amazon by Jeffrey Gittimer. Get it, Barbara. Another one. It's cool. Trigger is the same size, adjust the reaction. You load different bullets. Some are blank. Some are armor piercing. I agree, Greg. I think that most of us tend to react in a bullet piercing way. And I think you need to shoot more blanks. Those of you who have had a vasectomy know exactly what I'm talking about. Oh my gosh. Just a little lightheadedness for men. That crazy or what? All right. So we're going to leave now. Wow, more ones. Mannion, laughter works. Of course it does. Yeah. And look at all the people from all over the world today. So cool. Morning from beautiful Yardley. Chris, Good morning to you too, bud. Oscar from LinkedIn. I'm seeing LinkedIn is now back working. Where are you from, Oscar? Inquiring minds want to know. JG once said, my emotional past keeps me grounded in the present. Oh my God. I wrote about it already. I called it grounding. I better go check what it is. And I'm going to check right as soon as I'm done this podcast. Broadcast. What do we call the 959? Is it really a podcast? No, it's not. It's just a broadcast. But sometimes we turn it into a podcast like today. Awesome lesson today. My pleasure. Laughteryoga.org. Okay. What is it .org? They don't make any money over there, or they make money and try not to pay taxes. Bullshit. Pay your fucking rent to live in America. That's all I'm saying. Churches and synagogues, pay close attention. It's going to be your time to cough it up. They want to tax the rich. What for? Rich people cause the economy to prosper. It's the people that don't pay any taxes at all that drive me up a wall. Just saying. It's pleasure. Son of survivors as well. Yeah. Good man. Good man, Ari. Sounds like a cool name for a band, the Rat Holes. Ladies and gentlemen, with their latest hit, Baby Let Me In. Here are the Rat Holes. Oh my God, that's so funny. Oh my gosh, another laughter yoga. We're going to find out what it is today and potentially join their non-tax paying group. Jen, I'm still doing it. I can't help it. This is the longest day of, I don't want to miss anything. Advertised as best known woman speaker during the 1920s. Elise Lincoln. Oh, wow. That's pretty cool. It's a woman. I always love when it's a surprise. It's a woman. She had like five names. But if your name, if there's a Vandergrift in your name, it means comes from money. Let her roll. I'm taking it and I'll learn about her and thank you. Mark Benner, historian. And sometimes it's Sherry sometimes using Mark's phone. Let's get that straight. Cool. Sometimes it's the woman giving you all the stuff. This is a little cheesy. No, it's not. Oh my God. Have a great week, everybody. Good. Oh, it's in the Poconos. Cool. I love the Poconos. Went to summer camp there. It's a Seattle grunge band. Oh, grunge band. Cool. The Rat Holes. As opposed to the people who live in California, the buttholes. No offense, Greg. Get out of there. It would be great to hang out before Christmas. Okay. Well, I'm going to try. Thank you. My pleasure. My pleasure. 82-year-old woman.
Cool.
Yeah, way to go, honey. Little pink book of responding kindly. Free for Eagles fans. See, that's funny. That's not funny. If you've ever watched the movie 1,000 Clowns, and for those of you who are still hanging here, there's only a few of you, but for those of you who are still on the thing, go watch 1,000 Clowns. It's the best movie of all time. Just saying. And Sneed, it's a perfect movie for you. And Glenn Bill, it's a perfect movie for you. And Dave Duncan, it's a perfect movie for you. 1,000 Clowns, Jason Robards starred, and Martin Balsam won the Academy Award for Best Supporting Actor. Phenomenal. Just phenomenal. Thanks for being a capitalist. My pleasure. You're not 75. Maybe in dog years. You're correct. Connie, you're absolutely correct. All right, now listen. I got to fly. I'm going to see you tomorrow morning on what was known as the Insiders Club. It is now known as the Sales Club. I will see you with an endearing message that will help everybody. You might want to make sure that you put yourself in a winning position by joining the club before it's too late. Great day today. From me and Jen.
Oh.
To you. Cheers. Health.